Hello, Mr. Arnacher, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I am giving very interesting and very instructive videos on Ecclesiastical History by Eusebius, in which I have come across some Samaritan preachers, apostles. And these Messianic Jews, when they have overpowered the churches, they call those apostles heretic or Gnostic. So they, by giving them a bad name, under the shadow of the Emperor Constantine, to whom they have flattered, they were killing those apostles, the light of Christ Jesus. As stated in Matthew 12:43-45, Christ Jesus cleansed the house, our hearts, you know, with his blood. And these Messianic Jews, they are these spirits, you know, which were evil spirits, which they have been pushed out, the temple priest, who were pushed out of the hearts of the people. And when they could not find any place to catch prey, then they returned back after a certain tribulation to get hold of those people whose hearts were cleansed, and then put a yoke over them far greater than what the temple priest had been putting. Remember that temple priest did not kill people so much as these Messianic Jews under the Emperor Constantine, and when they became Pope, they burnt the people at stake alive for opposing them or for doing things which they did not like. So they were worse master, and this has been clearly prophesied by Christ Jesus in Matthew 12:43-45, that the house or the situation became worse than before. So anybody who preaches gospel today, as they have been brainwashed, these people, and they are called heretic by the standard of these book people. As I explained in the previous video, I go to Christadelphian Church in Reading, and when I try to explain to them the parables, they don't want to know it. They will tell me it's not written there. Where from you got this thing? And they call me rather heretic, and they don't like to talk with me. And I just amuse myself. So they were the living in spirit apostles, these Samaritan people, and dead in spirit Messianic Jews became this worse master, as predicted by Christ Jesus in Matthew 12:43-45. So do not be worried if we too are called heretic by the hireling dog-collared priest of Mammon. If you come across their works, our gospel, that mean of Menendia and the other people, they call it Samaritan, they call them sorcerers and whatnot. If you come across those, their works, you know, let me know. We will render exposition with pleasure. Samaritan woman at the well was Saint Fortina. I don't know whether you have any gospel by Saint Fortina, but these sons of Satan, Messianic Jews, call her a prostitute. Today these sons of Satan are bundled up in Israel, Matthew 13:24-30, for final burning. And they should turn to Christ Jesus if they want to save their souls. Because when you preach gospel, then you become son of God. As soon as you become son of God, you are eternal, like our Father. So in this dark age is the easiest way to earn salvation. And as in salvation, we are solitary, we make other people solitary. So these people call them heretic, they themselves were solitary. And their number is less, you know, because not many people are devoted to God, or there are not many people who are predestined. So they are very few, handful. And so they are the saviors, because they themselves have saved their lives, salvation. They, by making other people solitary, they also save them. So that's why, like people like me, who are preach Christianity, believe in Jesus, but I'm not a Christian. I have Christ in my heart. Without Christ, I cannot preach what I'm telling you in spirit. So I'm solitary. So I want to make other people solitary. I don't want following, because if you make a following, then you become adulterer. And the people who follow you, they become the prostitutes. So Pope is adulterer, and the people who follow him, they are all prostitutes. You can see how many they are. Because Pope is not going to give their account to God. Everyone has to give his own account to God, so you have to be solitary. And Justin, in the passage in which he mentions Simon, gives an account of this man also in the following words. Now, Simon may be another person. And we know that a certain Menander, who was also a Samaritan from the village of Caparatia. The situation of the village of Caparatia is uncertain. See, Harnax and other thing, was a co-worker. Co-worker is a correct word, you know, because we are fellow workers. We are not disciples. So co-worker is correct, this, and not disciple, as in Gnosticism, there are no blind disciples. But the enlightened laborers and workers, the apostles, are co-workers of Simon, and that he also, being driven by the demons, came to Antioch. So driven by the demons, they call them, as you know, to Jesus, these messianic, these Jews in Jerusalem, they used to call him a son of a Satan. So he had a demon in his, and he was doing all that miracles, saving peoples and doing thing by the power of the Satan. So these messianic Jews also turned around the same formula against these Samaritans who were apostles. So they say, being driven by the demons, they call him, you know, came to Antioch. Menandius, Antiochene activities is reported only by Justin. It is probable, therefore, that Tertullian used Irenaeus alone in writing his account of Menander, for it is unlikely that both of them would have omitted the same fact if they drew independently from Justin and deceived many by his magical art. Jesus was also a magician, and he persuaded his followers that they should not die. That is what it is, you know, because when you are become living in Christ, then you become Christ-like, eternal, and not like Adam. In God, we are eternal. In Adam, we are born and die.